So as the 35th anniversary year of the University of South Florida College of Public Health, we've been focusing on what we'd love to call cool things we do, and public health is full of interesting challenges. Ben Jacob is perhaps one of the most creative and passionate faculty members we have, tackling one of the world's persistent public health challenges, malaria, using technology, using his knowledge of community engagement, geography, meteorology. He brings all of these things together in an effort to find mosquitoes where they live and breed and stop that process.
Hi, this is Ben Jacob, College of Public Health. We're here with Mark Latham, the director of Manatee County Abatement District. He's going to tell us a little bit about some of the problems here in this county with some of our vectors and nuisance mosquitoes.
Well, this area here is quite a common production site for our salt marsh mosquitoes, Aedes tenorhynchus. In natural conditions, you find them associated with mangrove swamps in the upper marsh of the mangrove swamps. But where you've got disturbed land close to the mangrove swamps, any low areas within that disturbed land can produce these mosquitoes. So it becomes more difficult to identify the type of habitat you might find them in. So something like using spectral imagery and drones will help us a lot in looking at these smaller production sites. We're out here, we have inspectors that check a lot of areas, and obviously it's very labor intensive. When they find areas producing mosquitoes, which is usually after a heavy rain or a high tide event that has flooded the area, we will then either treat it by hand or truck, or if it's a big area like this, we'll use our helicopters to come in.
With the drone technology, by showing you where these locations are, you're getting more remote precision. That means it would bring down the cost.
Exactly. I mean, that's the whole thing, that, you know, we like to think we're good at identifying sites. And we have inspectors that have been here 10, 20 plus years.
Wow.
So they've got historical knowledge. But things change.
Absolutely.
You know,
Absolutely.
You get changing water levels, changing
Absolutely.
Sea levels, Fantastic. Everything. So you are getting, they have to look further afield. And some areas are just too vast.
Exactly.
These coastal swamps are too vast to really get a good idea of what's going on with one or two inspectors.
Exactly.
So yeah, so some other system that can do it much quicker.
Yes.
If it can be proven, will be a great advantage to us.
And that's what we're here to do. We're here to prove that we can use the drone technology here to help Mark and a few, as many other abatement districts we can here in Florida. Thank you. So our drone pilot, Nate, who's our PhD student at COPH, is about to put up the drone. We'll be looking for getting some signatures from some of these aging habitats along the edges of these swamps. I'm here with Nate. He is our PhD student at the Department of College of Public Health. Nate, can you tell us a little bit about what you're actually doing here besides just flying the drone?
So the purpose for flying the drone is to find a for sure known habitat, and we're going to get as much imagery and pictures of that one habitat as we can so that we can train the computer algorithm to locate other unknown habitats. So what we'll do after we get that first one is we'll go up higher to get more of a view of the whole area, and we'll use the view of that whole area, the video of that area, as a method to input our algorithm and to detect the unknown areas that we haven't actually been to yet.
So from what Mark has already told us, that they have an issue with not only locating the unknown sites but the cost. So I think what we're doing here is able to depreciate the overall cost for treatment of this nuisance mosquitoes using drone technology. Well, I'm here with Dr. Serum. He's from the Department of Engineering with his graduate student Mona. They're helping us using the machine learning algorithm object detection mechanism from the drone data. So I'm going to turn this over to Dr. Serum.
So the goal of this effort here is, you know, we want to take these images from the drone and also geolocate them, you know, based on GPS coordinates. And from that, we want to splice up the video into multiple frames and then check each frame using AI technologies, basically recurrent deep neural networks, in order to be able to do two things, you know, object detection to actually identify the presence of larvae and eggs, and possibly object localization, which is basically to tell within the image where exactly the source of the larvae or the source of the eggs are. And the idea is to feed it back in real time based on GPS coordinates back to these abatement districts for actually targeted mosquito control.
So the idea here is that we're doing everything in real time. We're trying to find and map everything that we have, and as well as destruction of the habitat within a near time environment. So I'm here now with Dr. Novak, and he's going to tell us a little bit more about the entomology of this program.
One of the things that we're really interested in is where do these mosquitoes lay their eggs? Now, the group of mosquitoes we're working with here in Manatee County are what are known as floodwater mosquitoes. The goal of this project is to see if we can identify these areas where eggs are concentrated very highly on soil before they hatch. And this way we can enhance application by essentially killing them when they first hatch, before they spread out, or even before they hatch.
Now, one of the things that I have to remark about Dr. Novak was we worked together on a program in Cambodia. We were looking at anopheline malaria mosquitoes. This is the first time that we've ventured in looking at an Aedes nuisance mosquito. And Dr. Novak, do you think there's a difference between the strategies involved looking for a vector, like say in northern Uganda, versus looking for a nuisance mosquito here in this abatement district?
No, it's all applicable depending on what disease it is.
Right.
So a lot of the work that we're doing here in Manatee County will be appropriately used even in Africa for that particular disease system.
So at the end of the day, what we're really doing is creating a silo of signatures of different a variety of vectors and nuisance mosquitoes that could be applicable anywhere on the globe. So outside of just working in the abatement district, we can look at also on foreign soil for looking at different vectors.
You know, our goal is the theme of our work is kill them before they fly and bite. And that is in the immature stage, whether it's the egg stage or the larval stage.
So we're hoping for an incredible outcome like we had in Cambodia as well as in northern Uganda where we're using the same technology. We'd like to thank you very much.